John chapter 5, verse 19 and verse 30 was the verses were given to me by Muslim. And those verses do not state that power is given to Jesus. All those verses states that Jesus calling God as the Father, which goes against Islam, because Allah is Father to no one. According to Islam, Jesus is not the Son of God.
Therefore, those verses prove
Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet, and Quran is false book. That's all
you
it
are
is.
False woman, and your teaching is false. Because the power being given. Now I need to talk. Because when you talk, you talk without stop. And you have big mouth, and you are deceiver, a liar, and insulting everybody. So the power being given to Jesus as a sign to this, to the one who he been sent to, which is a Jew. And the power, where was his power when he was hungry and he cursed the fig tree and he couldn't stand any more hungerness? Where was his power?
Let me respond to that. So, now you picked up where your brother left and spoke
away. He left because you insulted us. And you're insulting. We are talking about the power of Jesus. Then you go and you say a prophet is false. We are not talking about Islam. We are talking about the power of Jesus. So stay on the topic. We will be grateful for you.
So, Yahya, now you are picking up from your brother where you left.
Okay.
So, my question to your brother was, how come Jesus had the power to create exactly the way God created? That's all I am asking. Are you able to answer that question? And my question comes...
You ask the question.
I haven't finished my question. My question comes from Sura 5, verse 110, okay. And also you have the same thing in Sura 3.
Well, this is how she's defending Christ. She's defending Christ by critiquing Islam in this manner. False impressions of Islam, and then gets you on camera to make
Jesus the power to do miracles and wonders.
Christians are seeing the light. There are many Christians that have become Muslim, and
Jesus,
it's not you.
Please, brother, may I?
Sure, my brother.
Jesus, JazakAllah. May Allah bless you. God, Allah, he grant Jesus the power to do miracle and wonder
Jesus
as a sign for the people, the lost sheep of Israel. So when he performed this sign, it's enough evidence that he's being sent as a prophet and as a Messiah for the Jew.
Let's go back to Jesus' relationship with Mary Magdalene and all the disciples, how they used to pass them around one another. Ask her about that. Explain that to us. How did Jesus' relationship with Mary Magdalene? Tell us about Jesus and Mary Magdalene. Tell us about that.
Allah,
they pass around like a walnut slipper, did they? All the disciples.
It is only Allah,
Jesus and Mary Magdalene,
with his breath.
Why don't you have an intelligent conversation? Now you see, you don't like it when the boots on the other foot. Well, we're going to create all the Christians to become Muslim in this manner. Was Mary Magdalene passed around like a pink pipe amongst the disciples?
And then creates exactly the same.
Now we're getting to the cut to the question.
My question is,
your religion is false. No, of course you're the ministry's name is defend Christ. Islam doesn't run away from the
heart. Okay, it is about your brain. So that
to the heart and to the brain and to the heart.
Okay. So my question to you: if giving attributes of Allah to any other human being is
shirk,
why Jesus has the power of Allah? Jesus calls exactly.
Why you start Sunday school? Now tell me, was she not? So there is a real question. He gave permission to people to perform miracles. So, because he's a messenger and prophet of God.
They must be the minister and not be performed by Mary Magdalene was passed around like a peace pipe.
Yeah, yeah. Do you want to summarize? I mean, because the video is going on long. So yeah. Summarize. I mean,
what I'm saying. Mary Magdalene's relationship
with Jesus. His attribute is immortal. Jesus is mortal. His attribute is ever living. Jesus is mortal. His flesh and bones sooner or later will decay and turn to dust. So the attribute of God, none has it. And this is what Jesus teaches, that the Father is greater than the Son. The Father, he have attribute, lot of attribute, none of his creation has.
Okay.
Yep. So now let me respond to that. As you stated, okay, God is ever living. You know, according to Islam, Jesus is with God. He's still alive. He still rules and reigns. So you just contradict what your scripture teaches. You did not answer my question, why Jesus has power, exactly the same power Allah has. My issue is, if it is to prove that he's prophet to the mankind, to the Israelites, isn't it enough that Jesus is already making miracle to heal the lepers, heal the sick, raise the dead? Yet it is Jesus who creates exactly the way Allah does.
Okay.
That proves Islam is false religion, because the very passage you bring it to me tells us God, okay, now, God identifies God as the Father, which Islam tells Allah is Father to no one.
Okay.